How do you do scheduling in the Facebook Ads Manager? Let's say you want to run ads certain days of the week or certain times of the day. How do you do that in the Ads Manager? Now, it seems like it should be easy, but it's not as easy as it sounds, especially when it comes to budgeting. My name's Adam. I'm the owner of Paracore. We're a pay-per-click lead generation agency in Phoenix, Arizona. And today we're going to be talking about ad scheduling. We run some performance marketing campaigns where we deliver leads to buyers. And buyers have different requirements on when they will take leads. They may not take leads on the weekends. They may want them during certain hours. So ad scheduling becomes really important in those types of situations. If you're running ads to a sales team or a call center, they're usually only available at certain times of the day. So that's when people start talking about ad scheduling. So first of all, what I'm going to do is most people are familiar with daily budgets at the campaign or ad set level through campaign budget optimization. With ad scheduling, that's not exactly how it works. I'm going to create a new campaign to just show you how we set these up. So I'm going to do a conversion campaign. I'm going to name my campaign Ad Scheduling Example. Creative, I know, thank you. I also need to create an ad set just to show you exactly how it works. My name, my wife's name pop up. Scheduling ad set. And then we'll continue. Now, when you're creating a new campaign, you have a number of options, and one of the options is campaign budget optimization. And you don't see anything here about ad scheduling, right? Like nothing. In order to see the ad scheduling option, you have to set it at the campaign level, and you have to hit this guy right here. You'll see campaign budget, daily budget, campaign bid strategy, and still nothing about ad scheduling. So they really make you hunt for it. More options. And why there's only one option under ad scheduling doesn't make any sense to me. I don't know why they do that. And still, you can't even do it. So it says scheduling is only available with lifetime budgets. Okay, so we go to the campaign budget instead of daily budget, which is easy, we have to do lifetime budget, which is gonna cause some problems in the future, which we're gonna talk about. So $700 is the default, and now we can change this. We're gonna hit here, we're gonna say run ads on a schedule. Now you do not run ads on a schedule at the campaign level. You run them at the ad set level. So I'm gonna hit next. It's gonna pull up my ad set. So we have a variety of options here. And when we get to, this is ad scheduling right here. So this is already checked off because we chose at the campaign level. Now, what I will say is typically when you open an ad set, you're actually not gonna see that open like it is. This is typically hidden. We don't wanna do spend limits. This is typically hidden when you open the ad set brand new. So just remember that it's under the start date and there will probably be a little blue link and you're gonna have to hit that and then it'll show it. So this is what the interface looks like. And you have a couple options here. You can use the viewer's time zone or you can use this ad account's time zone. So we tend to use the ad account time zone because it's just sort of easier for us. But if you have something that's like viewer related, like it makes sense for them, like you know, you want people on the East Coast to see something at 6 a.m. and you want people on the West Coast to see something at 6 a.m., that's when you would use viewer's time zone. But if it's kind of more related to a client and like your time zone, it's easier to do your time zone, then we usually use ad account. Now, Arizona is a pain because we have a daylight savings issue where we're like mountain sometimes and Pacific other times, which is super annoying. So we will still do this, but it can cause problems. And then you're going to see this chart, and I feel like there's got to be a better way to do this, but this is what they do. And so you have hours of the day and then days of the week. So if I want ads to run all day on Monday, I'll do this. You know, let's say we don't want to run Tuesday, we'll do this. You know, whatever, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, it doesn't make any sense. And then on Saturday, we only want the ads to run between 9, which is this line here, and 3. So 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, and then ending at 3. So even just looking at the way that these are labeled is kind of a pain, but this will only show the ads during these time periods, or you can go every day like that, right? Or you can just mess with every single day. You can pull that drag that one on the bottom there, then whatever, right? So you have a lot of different options. So now you have this, this schedule here, and this is per ad set. So if you create multiple ad sets, you'll wanna do this for every single ad set. Now what I'm gonna do is I am going to go back to this campaign, I hope. Just give me 1 second here. Yep, I'm gonna create a new ad set because I wanna show you how to change many of them at the same time. scheduling ad set two, because this becomes a problem. So now we have two ad sets. I'm gonna close this guy and go back to campaigns, go here. And now if you're making changes to multiple ad sets, what you wanna do is you wanna click this and click this and hit this guy, edit all of them at the same time. And now you can change, see, this is what I was telling you before. It's like hard to even, I've done this 1,000 times. And it says they vary. So you actually need to change each one individually. It's so annoying. Each one individually to match, and then you can change them all at the same time here. So I'm gonna just do that real quick. I'm just gonna, you know, I'm gonna go just Monday, make it easy. I'm gonna go, so here's our problem. We'll go just Monday, and then we'll close. And then we'll hit both of them. This should work, I hope. And then now we've clicked two ad sets and we wanna change both of them to, so now you can see it's showing, it's not saying mixed values. Now if I change this, it changes both. So now both of these ad sets are gonna run Monday and Tuesday. Now the other really important thing to know when you're doing this type of advertising where you're just running certain days is the start and end date is very important because your budget is a campaign budget. We have done a campaign-based budget, not a daily budget. So because of that, it gets kind of tricky, all right? So our budget right now is $700. I'm gonna click in here. I'm gonna change this one. These have mixed values for some reason, the start and end date. So I'm gonna do start date, I'm gonna do it tomorrow, and then I'm gonna do 1 p.m. And then I'm gonna end July 31st. This is what I tend to do is the last day of the month just because it's kind of easy. And then I do 11:59 p.m. because I don't trust myself for Facebook. So that's for one. And then I'm gonna do this one, or this is maybe just the one I just did. Yeah, all right, so it's not. So 1 p.m. and then end date, July 31st, 11:59 p.m. And now I have both of these ending at the same time. They should. July 31st, 11:59 p.m. Yeah, I don't know why it says they're different. Go Facebook. So these say that they're different, but that is not the important part. The important part is that you need to calculate your budget based on the days you're running. So we just chose Mondays and Tuesdays, but I'm gonna change this to weekdays because it makes more sense and it's easier. So I wanna say, okay, we're actually just gonna do weekdays. So I forgot you can drag down like that. So this did both of the ad sets because they're both checked. I hit edit. Now they're both weekdays, no Saturday, Sunday. And I have a $700 lifetime budget. So that means that if these started tomorrow, I'm gonna go to my calendar. So the 23rd, so we have the 23rd, and then 26, 27, 28, 23rd. So 6 days it's gonna start. And so 700 over six is $116 per day. So these campaigns are gonna spend $116 per day. What I like to do is I like to actually change the name of my campaign and I say $116 because that then tells me, and I'm just like hiding my other campaign names right now, That reminds me that this campaign is spending $116 because I can't look at the daily spend. It's showing a lifetime spend. And if I've run this campaign for 2 or 3 months, the lifetime spend is gonna get, I mean, look at these. This lifetime spend is $88,000. This campaign is $850 a day, not $88,000. So I don't know what the daily is unless I look at, unless I can look at the campaign or I dig in. So I like to do this in the campaign name, $116 per day. Oops, I wanna save that. Yeah, so it's saved. And then, so it's $116 per day. So great, so perfect. It's gonna end the 31st though. So now we're gonna get to the 31st. And what we need to do is, unfortunately, we need to change the lifetime budget to run through the month of August. Because this is set to end on the 30th. It won't actually show it here. It shows it, this says ongoing, this is wrong. Once you publish it, it'll actually change to July 31st. So this will show July 31st. And it'll be the end date. It'll be $700, $116 a day. Now let's just say We spent the $700 and we go, you know what? We want to go to 150 a day in the month of August. Well, we don't just change it to 150 a day like this daily budget here, this little retargeting budget. We have to change the lifetime budget. So I create this very small calculator just for illustrative purposes. And you can create this on your own. This is not like something that's difficult to do. I'm going to show you the formulas. So what it does is it says, all right, what's your maximum spend, which Facebook just changed and is stupid that they call it maximum, but that's the all-time spend, the lifetime spend. And because our budget right now is $700 lifetime, and we're pretending like it's July 31st, we're going to say, okay, it's $700. And then we're going to change the end date. And this is like we're doing this on like July 31st, right? Change end date to August 31st. So we need to change the end date of the ad sets to August 31st because we need this to expand into August. So we're pretending like today is July 31st. So I'm gonna hit this guy. I'm gonna choose both these. I'm gonna hit edit and I'm gonna go, okay, that's not gonna work. All right, I'm gonna do one at a time and I'm gonna go, okay, now we're going out to August 31st. I'm just doing 1 month at a time because that for me is just kind of easy to monitor, although it's kind of a pain. You got to change it all the time. And all right, so great. So we changed it to August 31st. Days left in the campaign. This is days left active in the campaign, not days left until August 31st. This is how many days are we going to run the ads? Do we want the ads running in this campaign? So there's 7 days in a week. There's 31 days in August, I believe. Correct. There's 7 days in a week. There's 31 days in August, but we're only running ads 5 days a week. We're not running ads 7 days a week. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at August, and I literally just count. And I like to count in fives by the week blocks. This is Sunday. This is Saturday. So I say, okay, well, the first is Sunday. So I go 5, 10, 15, 20, 22. 22 weekdays in the month of August, even though it's 31 days. If you want to be really careful, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, blah, 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 count up to 22. So you go, okay, there's 22 days. No formulas yet. This is just a number. We said we wanted our new daily budget to be 150. So we're going to do that. And this is the only formula that we have. So the new lifetime budget that we're going to set, make this more clear, on July 31st is $23,200. Now that may seem like a lot. I want to make sure this is right. I feel like this is wrong. This is wrong. C5 times C4. That is a lot. Good. So we want to do the daily budget times the days left in the campaign and add it to the amount of money we've already spent. So yeah, it's not 23,000. So $150 times 22 days, C5 times C4 plus how much we've spent. We take that dollar amount. And I want to point out something real quick. I just had an improper calculation of $23,000. Like, just pay attention to that. If you're like in your gut, you're like, that doesn't make sense. Like, that just seems way too high. Like, just think about it for a second. I mean, it's like, all right, does this make sense? Like, does this like, is it roughly in the ballpark? And $23,000, no, it's not. We're spending $150 a day. It just doesn't make any sense. So we're going to go over here. We're at $4,000. We're going to hit lifetime budget, $4,000. Remember, this is July 31st. This is not July 22nd. And then we're going to hit publish. And then it's going to run $150 a day. Now, what happens if we say, all right, we want to start running ads on Saturday? So you have to do the same calculation again. You have to go in here. You have to go into each one. And we're going to do both. And I'm going to go a little bit off the reservation here and get a little bit crazy. So now we're adding Saturday, right? So we're going to close that. We can publish it if you want. And then we're saying, okay, I'm not going to make this too tricky. Let's just pretend like it's July 31st again. Let's say, okay, you published it. And then they're like, oh, we changed our mind 5 minutes later. Like that never happens, right? We want to run on Saturday. It's like, great. So now we have to add Saturdays in. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4 Saturdays in the month of August. So we're going to change this to 26 because there's 26 because there's 4 Saturdays left. Now we got to increase it to 4,600. Okay. So now we're increasing the lifetime budget to 4,600. Now a shorthand way to do this, if you want to just increase the daily budget, and this gets so complicated. If you just want to say, all right, we're going from $150 to $200, $50 a day, and today is the 13th, it's the 14th, it's a Saturday, and I want this to start on the 16th. Now, just stay with me here, okay? So we've gone through and we're like, okay, great. We've spent a certain amount of money up to this date. So let's just pretend like the maximum that we've spent is, we're gonna say, well, I can figure it out. So 150 times 10 plus 700 is 2200. So we're gonna say 2200, right? And we're like, okay, I wanna increase my budget by $50 a day. I gotta go through all these like weird calculations. So what I do is I say, okay, we've spent 2200. I know that I have 6, 12, 13, 14 days left in my time period. So I go, okay, that's 14 times 50. I've already spent 2200. Really, the only thing I wanna do is I want to, actually, I don't even need this. I don't even know why I told you that. We just look at the number of days left. The only thing I wanna do is I'm just gonna say my lifetime budget, which was $150, now I'm just gonna add $700 to it, and it's gonna be $5,300, because I'm only adding $50 a day for 14 days, and my budget originally was $4,600, so if I wanna add 50 a day, then I'm just gonna add $700 to this budget, and we're gonna be at $5,300. So I come back here. Don't forget to change your campaign name. I should have changed this one before, but I was at 150 before, and now I'm at 200. Save the draft, and then I'm at 5,300. All right, that's how we do budgeting with day parting, with daily scheduling. Super annoying. Setting it up is a little bit annoying, and then budgeting it is annoying too. But that's how we do it here at Paracore. You can see this campaign, lifetime budget, there's a retargeting campaign. So a couple leads trickle in off hours, it's fine. Lifetime budget. And that's how we do it. And I change these all the time. It's very annoying and it's tedious, but that's the only way I know how to do it. And I wish Facebook would change it, but they have not yet. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment in the comments below. Please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, give me any feedback, I'd appreciate it. And we'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot.